What is going on, guys? So I bought something very cool behind me, and I want to give you guys a tour. As you saw from this title, 24 years old, Caleb and I, business partners. Caleb's in Arizona. Ooh, there's a skid steer, and I want to get one like that. It's very handy. Anyways, I bought this building along with Caleb, so we went in on this 50-50, and we're both 24 years old, and I'm going to give you guys a little tour of our newest car dealership. I sell used cars. We have a car lot in Arizona, and then this is our lot in BB, Arkansas. So if you guys need a car near BB, DM me, message me, comment down below. I will ship it to you. But we're getting this open. We're getting our license right now. It's a waiting game, but come on inside with me and I'm going to show you guys our building, and I'll walk with you and tell you all the details about it and you know what we plan to do with it. So come on. I'll show you guys the entire lot. So this lot is on one solid acre, or actually 0.98, so right under an acre. Completely paved the entire place. There is power. Sorry for the wind, guys. I'll try and muffle it with my phone. There is power to this sign, so you can get a digital sign hookup. You can see it there. There are, I think, one, two, three. There's three lights. Four, five, six. So six lights for the front inventory, all roadside on the main road in BB. It's 1 acre again, completely paved entirely. And we bought this lot. We did not rent it. We bought it. So this is the building. The building is 2,900, I think, and 50 square feet, or 2,850 inside. There's a little cubby hole, because if you measure the building this way and that way, it's actually 3,000 something, but they don't count that because it's technically an awning, which, not this, but I'll show you guys in just a second. But a lot of glass doors. You can see your customers. The double doors opened up. If you come in, here's the lobby. And the building was built, I think, in 96 or 02. I forget. One of those numbers. I've done a lot of like comparables and I forget what this one was. But here's the lobby. You guys can see everything that's in here was left as is. So some of this stuff we'll keep, some of it we won't. Some of these older chairs, you know, it's not that handy, but I think I like a lot of the cooler posters. If you come over here, you can see all that stuff. They have an open sign, everything really. I mean, the carpet, or the floor is all redone. It was carpet right before they listed it on the market. It's been blacktopped and resealed. So the concrete is in good shape. They left this is really, really cool. So all these collectible cars, that's a really, really cool thing that I like. I mean, he definitely could have took that and said I wanted it, but he was being real nice. Really, really, really nice guy. The previous owner was, he left these are actually kind of rare. Comment down below if these are worth any money. He told me that he's like, oh, since what's his name, Dale Earnhardt, died in this car, these have actually became quite a collector item. And there's three, I think, right? Yeah, Dale Earnhardt. So three of those, that's pretty cool. We want to put some, you know, more modern stuff in here, maybe change the countertops because they're kind of old school. Here's the receptionist desk. You can sit back here, all that stuff. There's a map, all these little old car posters, which I like this is pretty cool to me. Even though it's, you know, not the most, you know, new looking stuff, that's kind of cool. Under here, there's some drawers. There's a little safe you can, you know, throw. So if we do buy or pay here, you can throw money in there, whatever you want to do. Printer, desk there. If you come down this room, there are four sales offices. For example, this is the one I've been working in, a little Sonic. I'm actually on ACV Auctions right now. You can see, so this is really just it. There is another map. They're big map people, I guess. I don't know, but there's a window so I can see if customers in the lobby. Boom, I can run right out of my office. Hey, what's going on? How can I help you? There's another sales office, another window. Boom, how can I help you? Stuff like that. There's a lot of, you know, filing cabinets. That's actually a really like nice one. It's fireproof and super cool. Come in here, there's a little blow up mattress. I've been sleeping here because, you know, free rent. So here's Caleb's office. He liked this one a lot. He claimed it. Huge window. It's a full length all the way down to the ground. You can see all that roadside. Boom. You come in here. Now check this out. I'm dead serious, rent free. I don't care what you guys think. Bed, memory foam, boom. We don't need 4 sales offices right now. I don't even really need 3. I only need like 1 and then the front desk person, honestly, at most. And there's 4. It's pretty overdone. It's always good to have that much room, you know, if the price is right and it doesn't really get too costly. So I made one into a bedroom. So if you come out here, you're on a little lunch break and you like to smoke cigars, I don't know. Here's the awning that I said doesn't really count as square footage, since it's technically outside. I kind of count it, I don't know. But you can do that. Our customers can actually go on a test drive, pull up when it's raining, and it rains quite a bit here in Arkansas compared to Arizona, where I was. You can pull up here, boom, they like the car, say, okay, go around the side door so you don't get wet, and then come into one of our sales offices. They come inside, and they can fill out paperwork, negotiate whatever they wanna do, just talk more about it. But moving on from here is 2 bathrooms. I don't really necessarily like agree with this because it's not, we're not a new, like we don't need that much bathroom space, but I'll show you guys anyway. So here is, let me turn the lights on for you guys. Well, I don't even know where the lights are. Anyways, here is the women's bathroom, ladies. Boom, boom, there's some extra space. That's what I'm kind of wondering is why there's so much extra space when they built this place. You got a whole shower. So you have another bathroom really inside of a bathroom, which is cool, but weird. I'll show you that in a minute. Here's the men's bathroom. Let's turn the lights on this bad boy. You got the man in here. You got a urinal. See, it's kind of like unnecessary. It's like, I don't know why they were trying that hard, but you have another bathroom in a bathroom. So it's a double whammy, 2-piece. But I don't really get their motive behind it. So I was like, man, I'll turn one of the bathrooms into a dang shower and 3,000 square foot or 2,950 or whatever it is square foot, I'll live here. I don't care. So then on top of all this, you have a lounge. And I just tried to hit the light again. And I just did that earlier in the video and that was pretty embarrassing. So here you go. It's in the dark, but here's the lounge. It's an old, we're going to put a new fridge in it. But you have a washing machine, you have a sink, and you can eat right here, you can talk, whatever you wanna do, but there's a little lounge area. My favorite part, by a long shot, is this shop. Oh, and the building is built out of red iron, so it's a very well-built building. It's not like any aluminum. I mean, that's red iron steel. That's not a cheap way to build a structure like this, which is very good for us because that increases the value by a long shot. But here is our 3-bay shop that we have. My dad bought that truck not long ago and we have a guy detailing it. He's down the road about 20 minutes at his car lot. But 3-bay car lot, each bay has its own drain. So that's really, really, really cool. I really like that feature because in the winter time, there's a water hookup. Boom, you can do that. You can pressure wash, you can close the doors, turn the heater on in the winter time, and wash your car all inside, get it all ready, and then back it out and put it on the lot ready for sale. This is the previous owner's vehicle. Letting him finish fixing it up and then back it out so he can put it at his house. You have washing machines for all your rags. So everything can be done in house, which is really, really cool for us because that saves you so much time. And people don't realize, like, I would pay an extra $500 to have a month. I'd pay an extra $2,000 a month to have a shop here because every time you leave the car lot, like a lot of dealers do, they'll leave and take it to a mechanic. Well, the time you spent doing that, what if there was a customer on your lot once a week and you missed them, just one customer a week? That's a lot of money you're missing out on. And honestly, it doesn't look good on your business if you're not there whenever they call you. So you don't have to hire an extra guy because you have everything, you know, on site, and it's a time saver and you don't miss customers. So it's a really, really cool setup that I like to show you guys, but boom, there's all that. And if you keep moving on, there's even more. So I don't know what else I could ask for a lot like this. I mean, this thing is awesome. Here is another room with more filing cabinets for sales, full on safe. Every single thing you see in here came with the lot, except for that's my dad's truck and that. But everything else, like the safe came with it. That's not cheap, guys. That's like a full, I mean, I'm 6 foot or 5'11", and it's 5 foot tall. So I think my math's off on that one a little bit. Like maybe it's like 4'8" tall. But if you keep going in here, it's an entire parts room. So let me turn the lights on here. You can store spark plugs, coil packs, radios, anything you want that's mass, you know, that needs to be changed often on cars. A bunch of batteries, so you don't have to go to Walmart or AutoZone and get, you know, 5 batteries for cars that went dead that week. You can have them here on site, boom, pull them out, install them, and you're good to go. It's got lights all up here. It's got natural lights, so those are ceilings, and that's just the sun shining through. No lights are even on in the office right, or in the car lot right now, and it's still bright enough to work on, let alone turning all those on. So on top of all this, eventually Caleb and I want to put a little loft up there. Wall it off, AC, boom, put a little loft up there. Sorry, I turned my camera around. Put a little loft up there. You can hang out, do whatever you want to do. That'll add value to the property. And I could even, so say I get 4 salesmen in here, and now I need that 4th office again. I could turn that into a little bedroom and sleeping area. I don't have to be fancy or bougie. As long as it's got AC a little bit and room, I'll put a ladder, boom, get up there, sleep. Now I have 4 sales offices again, but in the meantime, we don't really need 4 right now. So yeah, that is the car lot. I will go outside, close this video out for you guys. But again, I'm 24 years old. We bought this and you know, it's ours. So it's a really, really cool thing. I love selling cars, love buying cars. This is our 2nd location. We have about 30 cars at our other location in Mesa, Arizona. There's a lot of reasons. I think I explained in another video why we did this, because you'd be like, why would you buy a 2nd location so far apart? But there are a lot of legal laws in Arizona that are very tough to get around. I grew up here in Arkansas, about 15 minutes away. My dad, my mom, my stepmom, they're all pretty well known and have really good reputations. So it's a good foundation to start on. And we bought this ourselves. I know people are gonna comment and be like, oh, your mom bought it for you or something. No, that's the profits from the Arizona location put the down payment on this. So that's not true, but I know that I get brought up because the way I worded that. Anyways, it's a great foundation for us to start. And with dealers starting to ship now, we can cover both sides of the United States now that we have 2 locations on each side of the US. So I can sell to customers in Missouri, whereas if I was in Arizona, it'd be hard for me to justify, you know, the shipping because you're so far away in Arizona. But now we can, you know, anything in between we can cover, any car we want to buy online, we're close enough to one of the locations. So many benefits. But there is my car lot. I am 24 years old, about to be 25 soon. Boom, DeWitt Henry Drive, 1 entire acre, solid paved. We can put about 80 cars on here. And it's a little under 3,000 square feet, 3 bays, and I'm so excited for it. If you like this video, subscribe. Comment down below what color you would make this awning, because our colors are green, but the yellow looks really, really good. Thank you guys so much for watching. 24 years old, buying our 2nd location. Hopefully we'll have around 80 cars here eventually, and then, you know, 30 to 40 can fit at the Mesa lot, and then we'll start, you know, shipping, or maybe even get into the transport business and start Carson and more transport. Who knows, guys? Subscribe, keep up. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.